writer of words and planter of trees. Jeffrey Brown has that story.
It's Hawaii, so yes, you do expect to see a palm tree or two, but you don't expect this, a whole forest of palms. Some 3,000 of them of incredible variety. Fans of many sizes, twists and shapes of many kinds, even sharp thorns. More than 400 species from all over the world on 19 acres of land on the northern coast of Maui.
I can't stop them from destroying the Amazon forest, but I can go out and plant a tree, you know.
The tree planter is W.S. Merwin, now 87 years old, better known as one of the nation's leading poets. And the two pursuits, he says, come from exactly the same place. When he began the Maui garden, for example.
I was feeling my way and learning all the time from failures as well as from successes, and one thing leading to something else.
And how is that like poetry?
Exactly like poetry. I think a real poem always, in my experience, takes you by surprise.
There were few trees around when Merwin was raised in New Jersey and Scranton, Pennsylvania, son of a Presbyterian minister. He would first cultivate words and become a much read and much honored poet. A prolific writer and translator of more than 50 books, winner of most every available award, including two Pulitzers, a two-time poet laureate, most recently in 2011. In the late 70s, Merwin came to Maui and bought 3 acres of an old pineapple plantation. It was then very much a paradise lost, where little would grow after the soil had been ruined by chemicals and deforestation.
Somebody wanted to sell it for very little money. And I thought, it'd be sort of fun to see what you could do with a piece of land like this. Maybe you could save it.
One of the only things that would grow was the native Hawaiian palm. And that's where Merwin and his wife Paula started, first building up the soil and then planting, often a tree every day during the rainy season, grown from seeds gathered from around the world. Merwin didn't set out to create a palm preserve, but that, says Chipper Wickman, head of the Kauai-based National Tropical Botanical Garden, is what he did.
This represents, you might say, kind of a genetic safety net of palm germplasm.
And that safety net is needed, says Wickman, as palm species around the world face threats, even extinction, from logging, invasive species, climate change, and more.
What we know today is that 80 to 90% of the world's biodiversity exists in tropical regions. And today, 1/3 of all tropical plant species is threatened with extinction. This means that in our time, in our generation, we have the potential to lose a major part of the world's biodiversity. Palms are keystone species. They play a critical role in these ecosystems.
2 years ago, the National Garden organized an effort led by British expert John Dransfield to identify and catalog every tree, map the entire site, and eventually create a database that will be used by botanists and other researchers worldwide. In the meantime, as Merwin himself has aged, much of the care and tending has fallen to Olin Erickson, a Minnesota native who studied botany when he first came to Hawaii and began working with Merwin 11 years ago. He says his job is managing, not controlling.
The distinction is certain landscapes are designed and everything is in a particular order and it's meant to be kept that way. Mm-hmm. We're here, it's more organic. Things, the way they grow, we work with it.
That means pruning branches, which end up on so-called biopiles that later serve as mulch, and sometimes clearing areas of larger trees, like these mango trees, to open up space and sunlight for the palms, which respond in a hurry.
These palms started growing a massive amount of new roots.
Really? These are all, I can see they're new, huh?
Yeah, because look, here's the older ones. They're much darker. And they're gonna grow all the way down here into the soil so it can support its new growth that'll happen.
Wow, that's amazing.
Isn't it?
Well, look who's here.
And it continues to be an amazement to William Merwin, who still writes, still works and walks in his garden with Paula, even after illnesses have left him nearly blind and certainly slowed.
That's so strange too, you know. How can you describe what age is? Because part of you feels that you're still that child that was around when you were 3 or 4 years old.
Yeah. You still feel that part?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm not bothered by it. I mean, I feel very happy at this stage of my life. And I see people who are frightened by being older. And I don't mean that I wouldn't happily be 20 years old again in certain respects, but I'm not. And it would be silly to waste time daydreaming about if only I were 20 years old again, you know. It's more interesting to figure out how do I see the world now. A marvelous thing about a garden that people who haven't done it don't know is that between when you first came here this morning and right now, look at the difference. The light changes, the wind changes, the time of day changes, and the whole thing is different. It's moving all the time. It's not static. It makes you uneasy to be in a place that's changing like that. Then that tells you something about yourself. It doesn't tell you much about the garden.
And now the garden will live on beyond the lifetimes of the Merwins, who've created a nonprofit conservancy with a land deed giving permanent protection to the palm collection. From the northern coast of Maui, I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.